Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about a very important concept in marketing. Perhaps it's an interesting concept for all the marketing learners, which is nothing but marketing mix. Marketing mix, developing marketing mix is the third stage in the marketing process. See, after deciding on the overall marketing strategy, a company is now ready to begin planning the details of the marketing mix, which is one of the major concepts in modern marketing. Let's have a look at the explanation given by Philip Kotler for the concept marketing mix. Marketing mix is a set of controllable and tactical marketing tools that the firm blends to produce the response it wants, it desires in the target market. Therefore, you can rightly understand that the elements of marketing mix, which are named as controllable and tactical marketing tools, need to be blended in an order as a cohesive unit, or to be blended in such a way one support the other, so that the marketer can get the desired response from the target consumers. The marketing mix consists of everything the firm can do to influence the demand for its market offer. Let us have a look at the origin of marketing mix. As far as the early 1940s, the four P's can be attributed to marketer and academic Mr. E. Jerome McCarthy. The many possibilities can be collected into four groups of variables known as the four P's of marketing mix. They are nothing but product, price, place, and promotion. Later in 1990, a seemingly cooler cat, Mr. Robert F. Lauterbone, proposed an alternative framework for the four P's. The newly suggested framework by Mr. Robert is known as four C's. We will have a look at the four P's given by McCarthy, then the four C's given by Mr. Robert, then the four C's suggested by Philip Kotler as well. Let us have a quick look at the first P, which stands for product. Product means the goods and service combination a company offers to its target market, the target customers. It includes the variety, quality, design, features, brand name, packaging, and services. We could in fact discuss about each of the concepts for more than an hour. But keeping in mind the limitation of time, we will restrict our discussion to the basic concept of product alone, not its the additional features or the salient features of a product. See, product should be designed by a company as a bundle of satisfaction. It is not simply a bundle of features. It's not simply a bundle of features a product could have. It should be designed in such a way the consumers look at it as a bundle of satisfaction. Or as rightly said by Philip Kotler in the first C, it should be perceived by the consumers as a good solution, an appropriate solution for their problems. That is why he stated customer solution. Product is nothing but customer solution. Whereas Robert has suggested it as what? Consumers. So the product has to be designed keeping in mind the consumers. Keeping in mind the consumers. That means the consumers' needs and wants. That is what marketing concept all about. Whatever you as a company plan out as a product or a market offer, you have to keep the priorities and preferences of consumers. The second P stands for price. This is what the economic value the consumers pay, which is rightly said here. Price is the amount of money customers have to pay to obtain the product. It includes list price, discounts, the decisions related to fixing price, you know, the MRP or the discounts, allowances, payment period, the credit terms, what you extend to your customers. All these decisions are planned out in the name of price of a market offer. How price of a market offer has to be planned? Considering the cost, not simply the manufacturing cost of the market offer. It is the cost, customer's cost. That means keeping in mind the affordability of the customers, the purchasing power of the customers, price of a commodity has to be set. Many times, you know, we notice for a product which is much more valuable, are much awaited, you know, by the customers. They are ready to pay even more than the price the company has fixed for it. When customers receive the benefits more than their expectation, and definitely they will be ready to pay a higher price, you know, for the commodity, and which is more than what is the present price fixed by the marketers. So you need to consider the perceived value of the customers also when you determine price for a commodity. See, obviously, another important point you need to understand is that the company cannot determine price of a commodity or a market offer which is below than its cost. No company is affordable to set price below than the cost of making the product, and it cannot sustain for a long time, right? Probably to beat the competition, right? To attack the competitors. Once in a while, you can bring down the price. Or if the product is getting outdated, obsolete, if you want to push out the manufactured stock and stop production of it, and definitely you can go for such a situation where price could be set below than the cost. But in the normal situation, it's not affordable for any company to set price below than the cost of making the product. Then the third P is nothing but place. It was previously known as physical distribution. These P's have to be really understood in the same order. You understand, right? Fine. What is that the corresponding C suggested for place, for physical distribution, which was previously physical distribution, now it is place. Convenience. And here Kotler has also stated customer convenience. So the product which you manufacture as a company should be made available as per the convenience of the customers. It should be made available within the vicinity in which customer is comfortable in looking for your product, in buying your product. The days have gone when companies were making the customers to come to their place to buy whatever they offered. It was like production stage. But now, it is not like that. In marketing stage, you are responsible as a marketer to reach out to the customers with your market offer. So, you plan out the strategies like what kind of transportation, what type of storage, then regarding, you know, place, the decisions like what about the type of assortments, the channels, the coverage area, whether you're going to follow intensive distribution. Its intensive distribution is suitable for FMCG. You can make your product available everywhere almost, so that, you know, the customers find it very convenient to buy the product when they require it. And it could be like, you know, exclusive distribution, you know, for say cars which are targeted upon the middle class customers, or the cars that are bought for necessities, or cars that are bought, you know, for fuel consumption, like that. So such cars could be distributed using exclusive distribution. You understand? Right. So this is what about, you know, the idea behind, you know, intensive distribution we discussed, exclusive distribution also we discussed over here. And for other, you know, luxurious cars, you know, you can go for, having outlets, distribution outlets here and there, not very many. Probably, you know, for a zone in the state, in a province, you know, you can have a particular distribution point. The customers, you know, would be ready to even travel places, you know, for about 100 kilometers or more than that also to reach out to the point of the dealers to buy the cars which are accepted to be status symbols, not the cars for necessities, you know, you understand, right? So that's what about, you know, you have to offer convenience to the customers in the name of distribution. That is what the fourth P and the corresponding fourth C's as well. Then the next one is about promotion. Promotion means activities that communicate the merits of the product. Promotion could otherwise be called as a marketing communication also, right? And persuade target customers to buy it. So by explaining the merits are the reasons why one should buy your brand, ignoring the competing brand, should be very clearly explained. You need to follow proper appeals, whether, you know, emotional appeals are suitable or rational appeals are suitable. You need to follow and considering the nature of the product or the reason why people should buy your product, and you design your marketing communication. The marketing communication could be advertising, it could be personal selling, or it could be done through sales promotion, or public relations, or direct marketing, and now the latest one is online marketing. See, these are all the popular promotion tools that are widely used in India by the marketers of different products. But do you have a standard set of combination of these promotion tools? No, the combination which you choose for your promotion of a product could vary depending upon the nature of the product. For promotion of a pharmaceutical product, medicines, you depend more upon personal selling and more upon sales promotion, giving samples to the doctors, right? Then other free gifts, things like that. Then you depend lesser upon advertising. Advertising there is nothing but, you know, the brochures or the pamphlets, whatever, you know, the medical representatives give away to the doctors to enlighten the doctors on the ingredients of the medicine or how far the particular company's medicine is better than that of the competition. Then you can depend less upon public relations, direct marketing, and so on. Not necessary that you should choose all the tools of promotion mix for the promotion of your product. And similarly, for the promotion of fast-moving consumer goods, I'm sure the first promotion tool you should follow is advertising. You have to give more weightage for advertising. More amount of your promotion budget should be allocated towards advertising. The advertising could be through the suitable means. If television is more suitable, you go for spending more money on television advertisements. If you feel for products like cars or, you know, I mean, luxurious vehicles, you know, you can really spend more amount of money, promotional budget on print advertisements. Advertisements through specific magazines, you know, meant for automobiles. Then less upon personal selling. Then for the cars that are targeted upon middle class, you can spend more on sales promotion. During selective seasons, you can offer them discount so that they are motivated to buy your car, you know, during such seasons. This is what about, you know, the idea behind it. There are companies like Amway, which simply practices direct marketing. But now only, you know, and it's that, you know, it has opened retail counters, you know, things like that. It is also moving towards adoption of other tools of promotion. Then online marketing, you know, and they say like companies like Amazon and, you know, and many other companies now they have, they are e-tailing, they involved in e-tailing, and that's what about here, you know, we can name as online marketing. And what about the corresponding C suggested by Robert and, you know, Philip Kotler for the fourth promotion tool, promotion or marketing communication? It's nothing but communication, customer communication. And that's what they have suggested. And it is what I rightly explain as well, you know, as corresponding C's for promotion. All your marketing efforts in the name of promotion of your market offer should be planned in such a way they are the tools for communicating with the customers. You should be very, very careful in the style of your communication. What style you follow in your communication plays predominant role in the success of the communication. I remember once a marketing executive rightly said that plain space speaks more than the printed space. See, since you pay huge amount of money for the print advertisements, you keep on printing, you know, everywhere the space, you know, which you hire in a newspaper or in other forms of the print media, might be magazines or journals. But it won't work out. I have also written an article, you know, that, you know, there is a form of advertisement which is called advertorial, right? Try advertorials to overcome the commercial clutter, to overcome the challenges of commercial clutter. You know, it was something fantastic, you know, and you give away your advertisements in the form of editorial content. And that is what I have suggested. You can browse in Google and come to know. It's also available in ResearchGate, right? It's a fantastic, you know, I mean, a different form of advertisement. And many times, you know, and the readers of newspapers, you know, just, you know, pass through the pages where advertisements are filled. They are very particular in reading the editorial content. So to overcome this particular challenge, you know, if you want your advertisement to stand out, give away your advertisement in the form of editorial content. And so that, you know, the readers, like they are reading editorial content, they will read out your advertisement and eventually they come to know it is also an advertisement. But when they realize that it is an advertisement, you have already communicated, you know, to the target audience what you want to communicate. This is what about the strategy. It is ethical, but you need to print the word advertisement at the end of the editorial form of advertisement, which is otherwise called advertorial. So this is what about the idea behind, you know, promotion or marketing communication, which is the fourth P of marketing mix. Now let's come to the conclusion here. The marketing mix consists of tactical marketing tools, the four P's, that's what we discussed, that are blended. This is what very important, that are to be mixed up into an integrated marketing program. One P of the marketing mix should support other P's. You understand, right? There should be a support between one and other P's of marketing mix. There should not be any contradiction between the P's which you have planned for your market offer. A good example, when you design a product which is a luxurious product, like a BMW, which is a car meant or, you know, accepted to be status symbol. It's not a car, you know, people buy for basic transportation. When you design such a product, the price should also be set accordingly. And people will not really accept, you know, the fact that you set low price for a status symbol you have designed and marketed. So you should set higher price comparatively. And that is what expected by the customers as well, for a BMW, for an Audi car, for a Mercedes-Benz car, like that. Then the next one is about, what about the third P, the distribution. You should not make such a luxurious product available everywhere. Don't go for intensive distribution. You understand, right? Don't go for intensive distribution. And don't go for, exclusive also. You can go for, extensive distribution. That means what? And here and there for a zone, you can divide a state into three or four zone and make one or two, you know, dealers point for such luxurious products available. The customers don't find it difficult to, you know, and reach out to the dealer's point, which is situated 100 or 200 kilometers away. In fact, they feel it as a joy of taking their vehicle to such a place. See, if the price is increasing for a luxurious product, demand doesn't go down. It is like a product with the, you know, inelastic demand. Perhaps I would say a consumer of a BMW will be very happy to tell others that he has bought the same version of, you know, a BMW for a higher price. You understand, right? So if the price increases for a luxurious product or for a product of status symbol, people don't stop buying it. You understand? And so you can very well say such luxurious products are, you know, and the products of status symbols are associated with the inelastic demand, like products of necessity. You understand, right? So this is what the idea, you know, behind the third P place. You know, you have to plan the third P also in accordance with the first two P's. And what about the fourth P? Promotion for such a luxurious brand of a vehicle or, you know, and a status symbol, you know, any product of status symbols are, you know, a product for sophistication, and definitely promotion should be done in a very professional way. You can come out with a few television advertisements, and that too with a very high profile advertisements. You have to plan and, you know, release it. You can come out with advertisements for such products in special editions or special magazines for automobiles, right? And you can have a very colorful and advertisements, not too many things printed over there, a colorful picture of the car and, you know, some explanation about the salient features of the car, right? And what kind of status people are going to own by buying the car or owning the car, and that could be explained. You understand, right? I remember the advertisement given by Volkswagen for a particular variety model of its car. You know, when the customer used to, in the advertisement, they have clearly explained, when the customer takes delivery of the car, they used to say, take care. And we have crafted the vehicle with all sort of passion. You understand, right? It's done with the greater involvement and commitment of a team of people working in the company. And you could also take it, you know, in the right perspective. Though you buy it, though it is going to be your, you know, and your car, your asset, and please take care of it the way we took care of, you know, the vehicle when we were developing it, when we were making it. You understand? And that's the kind of, you know, promotion they have done for the vehicle. You understand? So such a high profile advertisement could be given for such products. If a product is targeted upon children, you know, the advertisements went for boomer, you know, and see, there is no logic behind, you know, something, but see, for children, and that is what they love to see. You understand, right? They don't see logic at all. They don't see logic, you know, in the advertisements for the products targeted upon them. So this is what about, you know, the idea behind promotion or marketing communication. So in the right perspective, understanding your target customers, right? Keeping in mind the other, you know, the elements, the four P's of marketing mix, you try to design each element in such a way one supports other. It becomes a cohesive unit which will certainly bring success for the company. And let's have a quick look at, you know, the extended three P's for service. You understand, marketing mix for service: people, process, and physical evidence. People, it refers to the people who are involved in offering service. They should be really professionals. You understand? And they should have empathic listening. They should understand the needs and priorities of the customers. They directly deal with the customers. And you can't expect a customer to behave or to expect in the same way what he expected or what he behaved when he visited your outlet last time. See, people are influenced by so many surrounding cues. And so you can't expect them, they are not machines. You can't expect them to behave in the same style. You need to understand their moods and priorities whenever they come, accordingly you have to act upon. So that you can remove the service gap, the gap of what you offer to the customer and what is expected by the customer through your service. And the next P is the process. It refers to the process by which you deliver your service to your customer. It is very important. You can't make people to wait for hours together. Or you can't just ignore a customer in the name of serving other customer. Suppose when you are serving a particular customer, the other customer comes. You just wish the other customer and offer him to, you know, sit for some time. And you can request him to sit for some time. You understand, right? You can politely deal with the customer. That is very important. cleanliness, you know, your the manners, you know, which you practice as, you know, the people who involved in the process of, you know, delivering the service is very important, the process. It should be a joy of receiving the service on the part of the customers when it comes to service. And the next one is about physical evidence. It refers to the atmosphere or the scenario in which the service is offered to the customer. And some, you know, and marketing experts, you know, say that even say for watching movie, you buy tickets. Ticket is a physical evidence for the service which you are going to consume. You know, after you buy ticket for watching a movie, there is a guarantee, you know, it is a document which guarantees that the particular seat in the theater on a given day for a particular show is reserved for you. You understand, right? So this is what about the meaning of physical evidence. So with that, let me conclude with the satisfaction that I have explained, you know, the meaning of marketing mix, the four different elements of marketing mix, you know, and I'm sure, you know, you would have understood the marketing mix in a better way, right? With that satisfaction, I wind up. Let us meet in the next video. Thanks for watching.